Next, we are going to import the bell prong. To do so, I'm going to File, click on it, then come to Import, and then go to OBJ. Alright, so we are going to import the bell prong. We created the bell prong earlier, now I'm going to click on it, and then I'm going to come over here to Open. Okay, we will do a little bit different here, okay? So under Basic, Load Type is the same. You want to add to the workspace, okay? Object Type. So instead of Avatar, we want it to be Trim, okay? The scale the same, the percentage 100, and the unit, of course, go to CM. Then I'm going to click on OK. Alright, so there is something a little bit different when we import it as avatar compared to trim, okay? So when we imported an object, trim, we have this glue bottle, which allows us to glue this prong onto this bell strap as well as bell buckle, okay? So I'm going to show you that. So first, I'm going to click on that glue bottle, okay? Then I'm going to hover my mouse over that area that I want to place the bell prong, which is right there. I'm going to just click on it. Now I'm going to just pan it down a little bit to see the result. Press down Option on All, left click to pan down, and I'm going to zoom in. Just place your two fingers onto the mouse pad and slide it forward to zoom in. It's really cool. And next, I'm going to just pan down a little more. Zoom in a little bit more. Okay. So what happened, we're going to adjust this bell prong to fit to a bell buckle, okay? To do that, I'm going to click on that bell prong. Once again, to bring this gizmo up, and I'm going to left click and then press down Shift on my keyboard and then drag it upward, okay? Then I'm going to click on that yellow square and just bring it up just a little bit. Then I'm going to rotate it to the right. Press down Command or Control, right click to rotate. See, you can see it's not bad. We almost get it there. However, let me zoom in a little bit. A bell prong a little bit too thick. So I want to change the size to make it thinner, okay? And also, not only too thick, but it's also too wide. So I'm going to change the thickness and the width to a little bit smaller. All right. First of all, I'm going to rotate back to the right. And I'm going to click on this. You see right here, this icon. That is the size changing icon. So click on it, and then I can just click on the blue arrow to just squeeze it down to just change the size a little bit thinner. See right there? Then I'm going to rotate it back. And I want to change, see the width right here of this bell buckle a little bit too wide. I'm going to just click on that blue green arrow and then click it and drag it to the right, okay? Then, it's also too tall. I'm going to just once again click on that red arrow and then drag it down a little bit to make it a little bit shorter, alright? Next, I want to move that prong up a little bit. To do that, I'm going to come over here to the, you see this size changing icon? Click on it. And this gizmo appear once again. So I'm going to click on that yellow square and then just drag it up a little bit, okay? So as you can see, it looks much better already. So again, I'm going to click on this square and then drag it forward to just fit right into the hole. And I'm going to just click on that yellow square to just drag it down just a little bit, okay? And drag it, adjust where it looks, okay. So next, I'm going to click one on the page to deselect. Okay, after that, I'm going to just press down Command or Control on the keyboard and right click and rotate to see if we can do anything to improve on it. So far, it looks pretty good, guy. Next, I'm going to click one on that bell prong once again. And I'm going to come over here to this property editor. And I want to change the color to... Let me use this eye picker. And then I'm going to just click one on this buckle. Then I'm going to press down escape on the keyboard. Then I'm going to click on OK to confirm. After that, a bell prong doesn't look even close to be metal. There's something we can do about that. So once again, come over here to this property editor. And I'm going to change. See right here, the type from fabric matte to metal. And there it is. As you can see, we just create this perfect bell prong for the bell buckle and for the bell strap. So after that, I'm going to come over here to this t-shirt icon and I want to turn that internal line off, okay? All right, next I'm going to press down the spacebar to simulate. Okay, so there's something we can improve on, okay? So we want to adjust this to fit this hole right here. So let me just zoom in a little more, left click to pan. So I'm going to come over here, click on the simulation icon to stop the simulation. And I'm going to click on the select slash smooth tool. And I'm going to click on that bell prong. And I'm going to click on this circle, blue circle, rotate it to the right, to the left. And I'm going to rotate the workspace a little bit so I can see right here. I want to drag this out just a little bit. And I want to make this width of the bell prong a little bit smaller, okay? Once again, come to the size changes icon, click on it. Then I'm going to click on that green stick out and then drag it to the right to make it a little bit not as wide, okay? Next, I'm going to once again click on that icon to get back to this gizmo. And I want to move it out. I'm going to press down on the spacebar one more time to simulate. So far it looks pretty good. So let me unstrengthen this bell strap so we get to see the result better. Again, just click on that bell strap and select unstrengthen. Okay. All right. So see if something we can do to improve on it. So a little bit crooked, I'm going to just click on that bell prong one more time. Then just adjust it a little bit over here. So we want it to be like just right, okay? That looks perfect actually. All right, let me press down once again this space bar to simulate. Then I'm going to just zoom out a little bit. I'm going to press down number 2 on the keyboard to get to this front view. And pan it over. This is awesome, guy. So okay, let me zoom in closer look to these eyelids for the bell right there. I want to double check a couple of things right here. So let me take a look at this circle. I want to make sure this opacity of the circle to be 0, okay? So that's what we want, is perfect. And we want the eyelet to be metal render only. That's perfect. That's what we want. Okay, so let me turn off this bottom floor. Now, let me go to rendering and I'm going to select render. Then click right here to see the quality of a rendering. Okay. All right. We just create this perfect bell strap and the eyelets for the bell. And I'm going to just zoom out. So this is the back, looks pretty awesome. Then come back to the right. Nice. Perfect. All right, so let me close this rendering window.
Hi, I'm Rose Willie from encoderfashion. There is more information under this video. Bye.